for those who don't know, Grafana Labs really deliberately, strategically empowers engineers. Engineers get a lot of agency to push and implement stuff which they actually want to see. And we dog food all our offerings. And this is why personally I believe we have so good offerings, and like the quality of our software is so good, because we really do use the stuff which we produce. We also have a system of hackathons, where 4 times a year, every employee at Grafana, go-to-market, engineering, G&A, everything, can take a whole week and work on whatever they like. The only thing which they have to do at the end is to present a 5-minute video, and then we rank and we vote and we have winners and everything. Almost 50% of the hackathon projects have already shipped or are in the process of being shipped. And not everything ships, but a huge fraction does it. And also, a lot of the features which you see, a lot of what you saw on stage, a lot of what you're going to see on stage is actually based initially on hackathons. But not all of this is production grade. Some of this is just fun, like, for example, Supergrot.
Hey, everyone. My name is Johnny, and I'm excited to be here to share something that we built during our most recent hackathon. So, if you've ever been in a hackathon, you know the energy can be wild with people prototyping new features and pushing the boundaries of what is possible to do with our products. However, at the last hackathon, Domas and I decided to do something a little different, a little fun, a little tribute to a little yellow dinosaur, our mascot, Grot. So we built something that was fun for us, something a little bit weird. So instead of explaining it, I will actually show it to you. Yes.
Thank you. So it's an awesome platformer video game starring Grafana's most adorable mascot. We built it using Phaser JavaScript video game engine, and it runs in the browser. You can play it on almost any device. And of course, we instrumented it with Grafana Faro Web SDK. So it's reporting level completion times, scores, player devs, coins, and other data. There's a public dashboard. You can find it on play.grafana.org. And if you post a good time or a high score, it will show up there for everyone to see.
If you want to try it out, and you definitely should, you can scan the QR code and play it on your device, or you can come and find us at the science fair section on the second floor, where you can actually play it in a little arcade cabinet that we have built for the conference. So please come check it out. We'll see you there. And now we continue talking about birds. about dinosaurs. So from dinosaurs to birds, with the next project, Birds Drill Down. Thank you.
So we are Ivana and Sven, and we want to talk about our little fun hackathon project. But for now, let's talk about drill-down apps. As we've just heard in the keynote, metrics, logs, traces, and profiles drill-down are all GA, which is really amazing. You don't need to know LogQL, PromQL, TraceQL anymore to write your queries. Drill-down apps really unlock a queryless and effortless, easy opinionated solution to query your data and get insights into the data that you are looking for. And they're really awesome. I can just encourage everyone to go and try them out. However, I think there's something missing in this list. What do you think, Ivana?
I think you're very right, Sven. There is something missing. Where is the birds drill down? And if you are all sitting here very confused right now, no worries. Let me provide a little bit more context. Me and Sven, we have a little side hustle, side quest going on. We are on a mission to make Grafana recognized not just as a monitoring company, but very specifically, a birdsong monitoring company. So when someone says Grafana, we want people to immediately think, oh yeah, dashboards and birds. It started all right here at the last year's GrafanaCon, where we shared how easy it is to create a bird monitoring solution. If you weren't here, or if you've missed it, here is a super quick masterclass. All you need is Raspberry Pi, then you need microphone, 1 hour of the spare time, and we have written a very detailed blog post that you can just follow. And of course, you need some birds that you will monitor. Inspired by drill-down apps and powered by awesome open source technology such as Grafana Scenes, Grafana App Platform, and Grafana LLM, we've built a full-blown exploratory experience for birds. With Birds Drill Down, you don't need to write queries anymore or build dashboards anymore. All you need is to open the app and start exploring. You will immediately see the latest birdsong detection. You will be able to spot interesting patterns and learn how things such as weather or air quality influences the quantity of the birdsongs. Moreover, if you are interested to learn more about which bird species sings the most or which bird species songs vary the most, you can simply sort by that and then align this with environmental data to learn some interesting patterns.
Yeah, and so every bird has its own page in the app where you can see a picture of a bird. We post some description so you can read about it. You can even listen to birds, so you don't have to go outside anymore, I guess. And nowadays, no great project comes without AI. So we have a 24/7 AI bird expert directly built into the app using the Grafana LLM plugin. And it's always there to answer your questions like pronunciation of a penguin or its pooping schedule, for example. So at our science fair, we showcased three main parts of our app. First of all, the bird monitoring setup, so the hardware, Raspberry Pi, microphone, and so on. We wanted to bring real birds, but that idea flew out of the window, so we brought bird plushies that make real bird sounds. And obviously, we demoed our app, Birds Drill Down. So everything is hands-on. See you at the science fair. And if you're not that much into birds, but more into games, back to Damas and Bogdan.
So, hello everybody, I'm Bogdan, and I'm here with my colleague Domas. We are both software engineers, and we are gonna start by mentioning our first hackathon project. That would be Faro. Some time passed, and then we had our second hackathon, and during the last day of registrations, we were there asking, what should we do? It should be meaningful, it should be fun, it should be useful, it should be, you know, a normal hackathon project, but we had literally no idea. So we wanted to answer a question. Does Grafana run Doom? So without any further...
Running Doom in virtually every device that can display pixels has always been a thing. MacBook touch bars, ATMs, or even pregnancy tests. But what about Grafana? Can Grafana run Doom?
So we created a data source plugin for Doom. thank you. It runs WebSockets Doom, which is a fork of Chocolate Doom compiled to WebAssembly by Cloudflare. It's rendering video into WebGL buffer in memory, which we then translate to Grafana data frames. We have 256 fields, one per color. And then we stream it to a regular time series panel with 256 overrides. So for every frame of Doom, it's rendering 64,000 data points. And on my machine, I got it to run at 15 frames per second.
No, that was my machine. And your machine did not run it at 15.
Come on. All right, we learned a few things along the way on how to max out performance for live streaming time series panels. It's important to avoid expensive on-the-fly calculations by explicitly setting minimum and maximum values for your data on the data frames. Also, to keep the list of fields constant, even if they don't always have any values for every frame, and push new data frames on window request animation frame tick. Also, if running Chrome, it really helps to enable Canvas out-of-process rasterization flag if it's not on already. So it is live on play.grafana.org. You can find it there or just scan the QR code. Or please come and see it in the science fair and talk to us. Thank you.
Thank you.